Hi, I'm Sammy Sadler, an applications engineer here at Instron. And in this video, we're going to talk about load cell measurement accuracy and usable range. Understanding these concepts is essential for determining your load cell requirements and ensuring you're complying with testing standards. On Instron product data sheets, we state the load measurement specification as a percent of reading down to a fraction of a load cell's capacity. For example, Instron's 6800 series universal testing systems have a load measurement accuracy of plus or minus 0.5% of the reading down to 1/1000th of the capacity of the load cell. The percent of reading tells us the level of accuracy at a specific force measurement based on the usable range of a verified load cell. In this scenario, if a 10 kilonewton load cell has a force reading of 1 kilonewton, an accuracy rating of plus or minus 0.5% would mean the actual value is guaranteed to be any value between 995 and 1,005 newtons. The usable range sets the upper and lower limits of forces that the load cell can be used to measure while meeting the guaranteed accuracy rating. This is represented as a fraction of the load cell capacity in our specifications. Any measurement outside of the usable range would not meet the guaranteed accuracy rating and should not be used. At this point, I'd like to talk about Instron's history, as it provides some interesting context around usable range for additive production and modern Instron testing systems. In the early 80s, Instron generally advised that the upper and lower 10% of the load cell capacity shouldn't be used, meaning the upper and lower 1/10th of load cell capacity. But as the technology in our testing systems improved, this guidance has changed. In the late 80s, the usable range was upgraded to allow for Instron load cells to be used up to the maximum rated capacity down to 1/10th of the load cell. In 1993, this was expanded down to 1/100th, and now our latest generation systems are even better. The usable range of our 3400 series universal testing systems are equipped to measure 1/500th of the load cell capacity with a load measurement accuracy of plus or minus 1% of reading. While the 6800 series can measure down to 1/1000th of the load cell capacity with a measurement accuracy of plus or minus 0.5% of the reading. Before I go through an example to show what this looks like with some actual force measurements, I want to highlight a few things you should be mindful of. For one, the accuracy of Instron load cells is based on a percent of reading, while the accuracy of some suppliers' load cells is based on a percent of full scale. The important distinction here is that when measuring accuracy as a percent of reading, the error scales with the force reading. Whereas with accuracy as a percent of full scale, the error is constant and becomes much more pronounced with lower readings. Many testing standards refer to ASTM E4 or ISO 7500-1 to define an accuracy requirement. For instance, E4 specifies that the testing machine needs to be accurate to 1% of the reading over a verified range, which we have been referring to as our usable range in this video. One of the main reasons Instron reports load accuracy based on the percent of reading instead of percent of full scale is to align with ASTM E4 specifications. In any case, we always recommend checking with your standard to ensure compliance. Now let's look at a real-world example of what you might see in your lab. Say we have our 6800 series system, which has an accuracy of plus or minus 0.5% of the reading down to 1/1000th of the load cell capacity. Equipped with a 50 kilonewton load cell, this system has a usable range of 50 kilonewtons down to 50 newtons, with an accuracy of greater than plus or minus 0.5% of the reading throughout that entire range. At a 50 kilonewton reading, the error would be within plus or minus 250 newtons. And at a 50 newton reading, the error would be within plus or minus 0.25 newtons. Compare that to a similar configuration by using a load cell from another supplier that states an accuracy of plus or minus 0.1% of the full scale. Remember, in this case, the error is constant. So a 50 kilonewton load cell would have an accuracy of plus or minus 50 newtons throughout the entire range. That equates to a 100% error at a 50 newton reading. In fact, in order to meet ASTM E4 accuracy specifications of 1% of reading, this same load cell could only be used down to 5 kilonewtons. To recap, our first setup using accuracy as a percent of reading had a usable range of 50 kilonewtons down to 50 newtons. In our second setup, using accuracy as a percent of full scale, had a usable range of 50 kilonewtons down to 5 kilonewtons. As you can see, the usable range of a load cell using accuracy as a percent of full scale is more limited, which means with other suppliers, you may need to purchase multiple load cells if you plan to test below 5 kilonewtons. Adding load cells not only increases expenses, it also adds complexity to your lab. Each load cell will need to be calibrated, maintained, and stored safely to prevent damage. Smaller load cells are more susceptible to damage, and calibrations are critical to ensure you are getting the data you need. With that said, it's important to keep in mind that load cell measurement accuracy and usable range specifications can vary widely depending on the manufacturer. So I would recommend discussing this topic with your equipment supplier. And that's a quick look at load cell measurement accuracy and usable range. While this video will hopefully provide some general insight into this topic, we always recommend connecting with your local sales engineer to discuss your specific needs. For more information, visit our website or contact us with any questions. Thanks for watching.